boys and girls, welcome to the Millfield Theatre. Tonight is a celebration of 25 years of Stage One. We shall celebrate the past to the present. Our history has seen tears and tantrums and a melted drum. We've had so much fun along the way, working with our wonderful students, meeting their families, and of course, our teachers. So sit back and enjoy as we celebrate 25 wonderful years of Stage One.
Ladies and gentlemen, boys and girls, it is my pleasure to introduce you all.
1989, Stage One opened its doors with some top classes, recruiting children with flair and passion for the magical theater to take part in its first ever production, Simply Dance. Mr. Daniel Mays. In 1992, Stage One created Easy Street. Set in a New York bar, this show followed music and styles through the decades. We were lost in time as we journeyed through space in 1994. Then came American Vacation in 1995. In 1997, we first came to the Millfield Theatre with a revamped version of Easy Street.
You've been hit back, you've been hit back, smooth.
We celebrated 10 years of Stage One and London's famous hippodrome in 1998. Then in 1999, we celebrated the millennium with a show set in the future named Expiring 00. Since then, we have produced shows such as Escape to Wonderland and That's Life and The Beat Goes On, Club Kids and Global Vibes.
I have one thing to say.
Hey, it's the first day of school, so play it cool. Grab your books, because you got the looks. So don't be a fool. Go back to school. You know where I'm coming from. You dig? Gonna kick off the show nice and fine and spin a new old field.
Let's go back first to the turn of the millennium. It's the Harlow Playhouse with a show created by Caroline and the Stage One cast. One of our favorite productions with all the cliche characters that you find at school. Please welcome on stage the School Days class of 2014 with The Best Days of Our Lives.
To Westfield and quiet everybody! Thank you. Good morning, class!
Good morning, Mr. Jones!
Oh yes, I suppose you think you're funny, eh, Ash? Suppose you think you're clever? Well, detention!
Yes, sir. Alright, I'm Ash. Anyway, I got this whole place pretty much wrapped up. And what's more, I do excellent exam results. Due to the fact everyone does my homework. This
might
Bob, by the way.
New girl!
Here, sir. I'm Geraldine Jones and I'm 15. I used to live in Kent with my daddy, but he said the school I went to couldn't cope with my braininess. So he moved me. I don't have any friends in my new school. Because they don't like me. I apart from Jemima, we get on really well.
Gossips!
Here, sir.
I'm a school gossip. My name is Dan Chalk for Daniel, and no one knows this. But I'm dating this girl from the year above. Don't tell no one. Because when anyone from the in crowd found out they hate me, and if that happened, I wouldn't be able to find out any good gossip.
Instagrams are lies. Selfie! I have three Twitter accounts, Snapchat and
Instagram. But we don't use Facebook. That's for your name.
So. I dare you, why do they use Facebook?
Who?
The gossips we have are
prefects! We are the prefects!
And what's that word mean?
Perfect!
My name's Jamie. I'm the head girl. As well as being a librarian, I'm mentored to all years. We act as ambassadors of our school.
We maintain discipline, help staff, small younger students, and we are very approachable. More than anything, we enjoy it.
All activities. We organise sports days, after school clubs, house music and drama clubs.
On Mondays we run a musical theatre club for year 7s. We learn about expression, boy, and give them a real confidence boost. And of course,
jazz hands!
This is how I make exchange student work.
Hi, I'm from LA. I've been here a week and everything is so cute. I love the uniform. Sweaters are great. I mean jumpers. We have so much fun at recess. I mean break time. Did I get it right?
Hi, we're the In Crowd.
I'm Stephanie,
Brittany,
Courtney,
Sadie.
We like cozy, good-looking people, and if you don't have a name bag, you're just not wearing it.
Adams!
Hi, sir. My name's Victoria. I'm the most popular girl in school, and I'm the most popular boy in school.
That's me.
Suppose you say we're eating up a ball?
It's getting a bit too much to keep up my image. And I'd kill for some mates who are a bit more safe for themselves.
And what's more?
Snitches!
Hello there, my name is Jacob Smith Grassfield, and it's my twin sister Ivana Grassfield.
Hello!
We live in Grassfield. We like school. Apart when naughty people do bad things like smoking the forest. Not mentioning any names.
Danielle, Ashley, and Mrs. Remington.
Yes. Precisely. Why can't they just behave themselves? Quite right, sister. I totally agree. Mother and I have this talk many times.
Miss Radish, she never puts her recycling where it should go. And Miss Smith, down the road, she thinks it's appropriate to go shopping in hair rollers and pyjamas at 3 o'clock in the afternoon.
Jemima Whiteshaw!
Present, Mr. Jones, sir.
Hi, I'm Jemima Whiteshaw, and I go to stage 2K High. I love maths, French, English, geography, history, Latin, and science. I have a new friend called Geraldine. She started our school 1 week ago, and my best friend is Donna. Donna, come back!
I don't really like my class. The people in it are horrible. Danielle is always trying to start a fight between me and Ashley, and I'm very scared. But there are some nice people like Robert. I like animals and make man codes, and one day I hope to be a teacher of garden greens. Oh my god, she did.
Quiet, everybody! Thank you! Right, now, Miss Shearer will be along momentarily for your English class.
Guess what, right?
What?
I saw Mr. Jones and Miss Shearer in the cupboard together! I knew he fancied her, because every time she came to the classroom, he would always take her.
Sorry, miss. I missed the bus.
You're always late, Cuthbert. Sit down now, Cuthbert. You know where you sit, next to Geraldine.
Hello. My name is Cuthbert. Please, about town, you mum? You're really attracted to a girl called Geraldine Jones?
Shh! Don't tell anyone.
Meeting in the library at lunchtime.
Hello, Cuthbert.
Hello, Jones.
Shh! Cuthbert's meeting me here at the library. What if he doesn't come? Calm down, Jim. It's okay.
It's oh so quiet. It's oh so still. You're all alone and so peaceful until you fall in love. The sky up above, feel in it, caving in. You never. So that's about a guy you want a lot. You want to cry, you crush your heart and hope to die. And then it's nice and quiet, but soon again starts another big riot. You blow a fuse. And then
While the others keep on talking, we keep on rocking.
You want Okay, roll call. Alex?
Yeah.
Andre?
Oh, yeah.
Nick?
Here.
TJ?
Present.
Brittany? Brittany? Brittany Spears?
Over here. Over here.
No. Here. My loneliness is killing me. Hit me, baby, one more time.
Oh, baby, baby, how was I supposed to know? Oh, baby, baby, I shouldn't have let you go. You'll never know.
Right now, I'd like to introduce to you some friends of mine.
Take you to a place you've never been before.
The glorious game, football. Plenty of drama on the pitch. And now cheering them on are Stage One. Now the resident cheerleading group at the Harlow Football Club. For 25, we bring this to life with some of our very young students. Check this out.
yourself.
Oh, Mickey, you're so fine, you're so fine. You blow my mind. Hey, Mickey. Hey, Mickey. Hey, Mickey. Oh, Mickey, you're so fine, you're so fine. You blow my mind. Hey, Mickey.
Inspiring voices, Mario Frendo. He brought singing to life at stage one, encouraging the students to use their voices. With a medley of songs inspired by Disney's Frozen, let's hear our choir letting go with some of their favorite songs.
Let it go.
Everyone's talking about pop music. In 1997, students performed Everybody by the Backstreet Boys at the London Weekend Television Studios. In 1999, we had our very own pop group named Yo-Yo. And in 2002, we created a very colourful production entitled Pop.
Turn it up and rip off the knobs.
Dirty pop.
Yo.
E.T.
Sick and tired of hearing all these people talk about what's the deal with this pop life and when is it gonna fade out? I think you got to realize what we're doing is not a trend. We got the gift of melody. We're gonna bring it till the end. Come on now.
Like a carbon tie, but I wear around my neck.
Such
a recognize that it's just about respect.
It doesn't matter
all the clothes I wear and where I go and why.
All that matters
is that you get hype and we'll do it to you every time. Come on now.
Ever wonder why this music is
get too high. It takes you on a ride. You feel it when your life starts to rise. If you just count and this is all you got.
Come on now.
This must be
Dirty Pop. Baby, baby, you can't stop. I know you like this Dirty Pop.
Now, why you wanna try to classify the type of thing that we do?
Cause we're just fine doing what we like,
and we say the same for you. I'm tired of feeling all around me animosity. Just worry about drugs, cause I'ma get mine. Now, people, can't you see?
It doesn't matter.
And the car I drive, or the ice around my neck.
It's
that you recognize that it's just about respect.
It doesn't matter.
The clothes I wear and where I go. You get hyped and we do it to you every time. Come on.
You get to wonder why. This needs to get too high.
Get too high.
It takes you on the ride.
Feel it when your
eyes starts to rise.
Starts to rise.
If you can't stop.
You can't stop.
This is all you got.
Baby, come on.
This must be.
Ooh.
Man, I'm tired of singing.
Dirty pop.
Did you ever wonder?
Thirty minutes of back to back slamming tunes.
Bigger, better, stronger, power.
Stay so cool, I'm Chile. I done made that melee on my way to that belay. Used to have a piggy bank, but now I got that bigger bank. Who cares what the haters think? They hate on me cause I'm doing what they can. I stay on that hustle, I flex that mid on my soul. Hate to bust your bubble, I'm on that other level. I'ma take it higher and higher, higher and higher. I stay in fire, tire. Keep burning like that fire.
Suddenly, it's 1989.
5, 4, 3, 2, 1.
Mix by mix, 30 minutes of non-stop dance.
Let's go to the beach, eat, let's go to the beach.
get away. They say what they gonna say. Have a drink, clink, found a bud light. That bitch like me, it's hard to come by. The Patron, let's go get it down. The sound, yes, I'm in the zone. Is it 2, 3? Leave a good tip. I'ma blow all of my money and don't get
I'm on the floor.
Shuffling.
Be mad, now stop.
Coolest, yeah. The coolest sounds you'll find anywhere. And you know it. Yeah.
Now this is a story all about how my life got flipped, turned upside down. And I'd like to take a minute, just sit right there. I'll tell you how I became the prince of a town called Bel-Air. In West Philadelphia, born and raised, on the playground is where I spent most of my days. Chilling out, maxing, relaxing, all cool and all, shooting some b-ball outside of the school. When a couple of guys who were up to no good started making trouble in my neighborhood. I got in one little fight and my mom got scared and said, "You're moving with your auntie and uncle in Bel-Air." I begged and pleaded with her day after day, but she packed my suitcase and sent me on my way. She gave me a kiss and then she gave me my ticket. I put my Walkman on and said, "I might as well kick it." First class, yo, this is bad. Drinking orange juice out of a champagne glass. Is this what the people of Bel-Air living like? This might be alright. But wait, I hear the prissy bourgeois and all that. Is this the type of place that they just send this cool cat? I don't think so. I'll see when I get there. I hope they're prepared for the Prince of Bel-Air.
Explosion! Flashback!
Flashback!
Chocolate, inspired by the latest Western production of Charlie and the Chocolate Factory last year, our students decided to create their own world of pure imagination.
Welcome to the tale of a delicious adventure in a wonderful land. Can't you tell it will be delicious? Can't you smell it already? Oh, I love that gorgeous smell. You've heard of Cadbury's, Hershey's, Nestle, Wonka. What's that you say? What's Wonka? You mean you don't know what Wonka is? Why, Wonka chocolate, of course. It was invented by Mr. Willy Wonka himself. It's the most amazing and extraordinary, most fantastic. All the kids love it.
Who wants a sizzler?
Can I have a sizzler?
How about a squelchy snorter?
Can I have a squelchy snorter?
I'll tell you what, kids, Wonka's got a new one out today.
What's it?
Aha, this is called a scrumdrumptious bar.
A scrumdrumptious bar?
Yes, indeedy. And I bet you're wondering how he does it. Well, are you?
Yes.
Yes, indeed. Well, let me tell you. Do you ask a fish why he swims?
No.
No. Do you ask a bird why he flies?
No.
No. They do it because they were born to do it, you see. Just like Willy Wonka was born to be a candy man. And you all look like Wonkerers. Now, run along.
Ahead, minds. Willy Wonka has announced an amazing competition. Find a golden ticket and you could win a dream trip to his chocolate factory with a guided tour conducted by Mr. Willy Wonka himself. Five golden tickets have been hidden inside the wraps of five golden chocolate Wonka bars. Your challenge is to find one.
Breaking news, our first golden ticket winner has been found. To find out more, let's go straight to our chief competitive correspondent, Cherry Sunday. Cherry, where are you?
Cherry, I'm in Bavaria. Here in this sleepy mountain town, it seems like a chocolate dream has come true. For local Butcherson and three times regional breakfast eating champion, Augustus Glue.
Augustus, my little pumpkin, smile for the cameras.
Augustus, how do you feel?
The story of how did it all begin?
Oh, when I was just a girl, I used to dream of a boy who would bring me lots of sweets. I'd be my short spot of joy. My new group was part of him, but now he seemed just like a crumb. Cause it turns out that this art was yet to come. So we were there, cutting my mouth, and something we began to do. And my neighbor and my kid, they had to beg there to make room. When the blessed day arrived, I asked you all to about the street. And the first word of the unfurled is so this little pig, little pig, without my head, somebody is in holding time. Our guru and the bite as well as mine. So inside this rather shocking is what I was covered up. There is no more nothing to love. Go ahead, Augustus, go to science, free your guts. Like my motor and my thunder, I enjoy a fancy bean. Yeah, my outside's soft and flabby, but my inside's made of steam. Yeah, I think it's in the back, and I eat some leg from leg. It's not me, but that's it, all and all be me. So this morning I was eating when such hunger to the tongue. I walked to the bar waiting for the night for breakfast snack. But the taste was kind of different.
Okay.
breaking news. Our second golden ticket winner has been found. Tell us all about it. It's our mistress of all matters, Wonka, Cherry Sunday. Cherry, where are you now?
Cherry, I'm in England. Our winner is 12. She likes ballet. She's the daughter of Peanut Billionaire. And her name is Veruca Salt. Mr. and Mrs. Salt, tell all.
Well, when our dear Veruca darling found out about Wonka's competition, she found a very keen interest in the competition. What Veruca says, I buy another store.
Yeah.
The sweat forms on my brow.
Veruca says,
we know where or when we better all sing out to
her.
And when Veruca says,
there's no reasonable doubt.
And if Veruca said,
there's no time to affect.
And if Veruca says,
obey. You better find a way to make a dollar stretch for
stretch, obey.
Now when she heard of Wonka's plan, she started to attack. So I told my peanut shellers, there's a tougher nut to crack. You've each a 1,000 Wonka bars, I'll share them at once. Cause when Veruca's happy, it's much better for her pappy. For 40 days and 40 nights, the ladies try to pick it. And always to the music hall.
I want a gold ticket! I want a gold ticket!
And then a girl cried out, and in her hand a panacea. A golden ticket on display, and what did sweet Veruca say?
Daddy!
Yes?
Daddy, off clear!
When Veruca says, it's like a battle cry.
Veruca says,
my jelly bar is fine. And if Veruca says,
please.
I know it's just a teasing course.
Mom, now out my fetch butt. Mom, now out my fetch butt.
Until tomorrow when I'll be good.
Breaking news, our third golden ticket winner has been found. Cherry, where are you now?
I'm in California, Jerry, where Lady Luck has landed in the land of local gum celebrity, Violet Beauregard. Here's her mother. Mrs. Beauregard, would you like to make a statement?
As a matter of fact, I would.
What kind of music do you love? We are the vultures if the culture's back. When you a mama, what you call a ma? And speaking of mamas, I'm the ma who has a little dollar with $1 million jaw. And when she gets to June, ain't no way she's gonna stop. They see the style and make your jaw drop. People of the world, allow me to introduce my old lady who is hard to the highest order. She's a dead baby Dutch, she's my daughter, and her name is... Well, her name is...
Well, my name is Violet Beauregard, I like gum. I choose to dance, name, and sensation I become. Throw half the air, I'm blowing this bazooka. It's really not nanny like the stupid old Veruca. If I'm a competition, I'm trucks, no crutches. And that is why my towel is the Bubble Duchess.
She's always on the bubble.
Bye, bye, bye.
Breaking news, our fifth golden ticket winner has been found, which means there's only one golden ticket winner left. The world has gone crazy for Wonka. The sweet has been flooded with chocolate, so where can it be? Who will be our fifth golden ticket winner? So folks, keep hunting, but for now, let's meet our fourth golden ticket winner. Cherry, where are you now?
Cherry, I'm in suburbia, in this little suburban town.
So, who is this lucky boy?
His name is Mike TV, and we're here to meet him and his family.
Well, he certainly is a very lucky boy.
Hello, 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 welcome. My name's Doris TV. Cups and doilies, please. This is my husband, Norman. We have a prepared statement. Oh, welcome to you, gentlemen and ladies of the press. How wonderful to share this day with you. You traveled far and wide. Don't be shy, please come inside. I played some putty for and cheese fondue. The reason that you gathered is to meet my little boy, the hero of the good old USA. So, now if you're all strapped in, let the press conference begin. Little angel, do you have something to say?
Ben, Ben, futuristic rodeo, wise casino, cool, just to hang on hard. Get your hard drive fool alert, Morris, I'll assure them. This is the life now, die!
Oh, Mike is just high-spirited, that's what the doctor said. He's just a mini version of my spouse. And they said it was a phase when he set the cat ablaze. But the authorities requested little Mike not leave the house, and so we let him sit at the computer day and night. He's promised me that he won't ever budge, 'cause things went from bad to worse when he chloroformed that nurse. Darling, tell the people what you told the judge.
Heck, heck, I sit the Wonka mainframe. I'm Captain Knuckle, just that I'm a superstar. Got his first round golden star. Never have to buy a bar. This is the life, now die!
It was just a shot of Frank when he stole that German tank. But we never wished that we had had a daughter. Medication sets us free, one for Mike and two for me. And at six I pour a shot of mommy water. It has been a pleasure having you inside our home, to see he's just a little boy at play. And though I break out in the sweats when we hide his cigarettes, we've got him down to just two packs a day. And now I'll go so Wonka's well, he'll make some brand new friends. I pray to God he fits in with the gang. But if there is no TV, it'll be like World War III. But for now, I'll let him go down with her.
Ben, Ben, we're hanging out for 50 hours. Why is catching the cool just to make the losers cry?
You can bet for sure this kid'll win.
Tell me where's my relief. This is the life, now die!
Thanks for coming.
Dear Mr. Wonka, I know that you're a busy man. You must have lots of mail to read. I'm writing for my family, 'cause there's nothing special that I need. The time you take to read this letter will be time well spent. Because I've made a list of things you might want to invent. This is a great list. Mr. Winnie the Wonka is going to really like it. Daddy's always on his feet. You may please grant me this one wish.
Gentlemen, boys and girls, the chocolate room.
I want it now! I want that one!
My dear friends, you are now about to enter the service.
As an elephant eats.
What are you at? Getting terribly fat.
What do you think will come of that? I don't like the look of it. Oompa, loompa, doompa-dee-da. If you're not greedy, you will go far. You will live in happiness too. Like the oompa, loompa, doompa-dee-doo.
Ladies and gentlemen, boys and girls, please put your hands together for our wonderful Oompa Loompas! Every student's dream, and our students have been lucky enough to fulfill that dream, playing the Drury Lane Theatre in 1997, London's Hippodrome, and Covent Garden Plaza in 1998, with the senior group performing Ghosts, and in 2012, Sanders Wells playing host to London Calling.
The party.
The race is on to get out of the bottom. The top is high, so your boots are forgotten. Giving is good as long as you're getting. Ambition, I'm better.
I said, oh,
do you think you are?
Do you think you are?
I said, oh, some kind of super.
if you wanna be my lover.
The battle of Britain is about to begin. Upon this battle depends the survival of Christian civilization. Upon it depends our own British life and the long continuity of our institutions and our empire. Let us therefore brace ourselves to our duty. Men will still say, this was their finest hour.
Thank you.
Just call my name, I'll be there.
Stage 1 has a long history with the Michael Jackson Days, hosted by the director of Thrill Alive, Adrian Grant. Students have performed at Hammersmith Palais, the Cambridge Theatre, and at the Hammersmith Odeon for Michael Jackson himself. And in 2011, we created our very own tribute to the King of Pop.
Too much. for me to jam. It ain't so hard 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 for me to jam.
Feel my world and dream around you. I'm so glad that your strength, I'll be grown enough. If you should ever find someone new, I know he better be good to you. Cause if she goes, I'll be there.
of mankind. That's the case. Never, never land. That's the place. A monster. You can see disappear. A monster. The worst thing to fear.
You're by yourself, but it's my touch you felt. I'm not a ghost from hell, but I got a spell on you.
Used to be watching me, used to feel better. Why you see, why you breathe, used to be better. Every time your name speaks, just speaks of me, better. Have a be, and never be.
What you just witnessed could be the end of a particularly terrifying nightmare.
Stage One has always encouraged its students to use their imagination and be creative. This is always encouraged in class, workshops, and rehearsals. To celebrate this, we invite you to delve into the wonderful world of fairy tales and child's play.
Take that, human, and that, upwards I'll slide you,
I'll rule
the kingdom.
Not so fast, I rule the kingdom here, and...
Children, up to bed and no more of that fairy tales nonsense.
Next time you will be defeated. It doesn't matter which way you look at it, it will happen. Among so many other incidents, accidents, consequences, acts of fate, I can see what is going to happen, and it's not looking good for you.
You too, stop falling around and finish tidying up. Where's my teddy? Oh, why don't you just give it to her?
Oh, please let me read the story. Oh, please.
There's a princess in a tower. Oh my gosh, that's just like me. Poor Rapunzel needs a haircut, but the witch won't set her free. She passes time by singing like someone else I know. As she has gone by, she sits and waits.
And she has gone by?
Uh-oh. A torturous existence. I don't remember this part. She wishes she were dead.
Give her hand.
But Sydney and Rapunzel find a millionaire. The prince is good at climbing and braiding golden hair. So I know you'll appear, cause there are rules and there are strictures. I believe the story books I read, but they can't deny my white knight and his teeth. Page number 23.
Oh, please, let's read that one.
Oh, please. Oh,
this one's about another princess. You can read it.
If I was a princess, I'd have a guy to the table.
I'm a princess.
Shh. I'm princess.
Seriously? I have a crown, a throne room, and a bunch of weird ancestors who'd like to chop other people's heads off. A lot. My parents, the king and queen, give me anything I want. A pony, a latest iPhone, a closet full of designer clothes, my own water park, anything my heart desires.
That's not fair.
It all sounds great, doesn't it? Trust me, it's not.
What about the fairies? This one's about a naughty fairy. Go on, read it.
This one is about a very naughty fairy. A little tiny fairy.
Tiny in size, tiny in shape, yet a little bit too big for her own good. Misunderstanding any tasks that fairies should follow, this one certainly is a mind of her own. Her name was Tinkerbell,
She was very naughty.
I'm not coming out.
Why not?
Because I get in trouble again.
Jack Jill, top the hill, to fetch a pail of water. Sally say, the subsequent fall was inevitable. They never stood a chance, they were written that way. Innocent victims of their story. And Romeo and Juliet was written in the stars before they even met.
I won't grow up. I promise I won't. I promise I will. I will see a boy father.
Now, don't forget your pillows, because you need them when you go to sleep, otherwise you wake up that deep. Toodles. Ha! Ah! Hello, boys and girls. Hello, audience. Well, allow me to introduce myself. My name is Captain Jack Sparrow. Ah, some of you may have heard of me, yes?
Yeah.
Good. Now, there are times, almost constantly, in fact, when I prefer to look from the world from the bottom of a glass of rum.
You won't be needing that tonight, Jack, will you?
Why is the rum always gone? Oh well. Well, well, baby. Well, you may have heard whispering rumours that Jack Sparrow be recruiting a crew to undertake a voyage out to sea.
Yeah.
Yes?
Yeah.
Not true. Now, if it were not to be true, you wouldn't want to join me now, would you?
Yes,
really?
Yeah.
We'll get in a line. Let's have a little look at you. Let's see what you look like. That's my crew. Right, there. Here we go. Right, so we got 1, 2, 3, 4. We need more than that. Now, I did see a young pirate in the audience today by the name of King Louis. Ah, there you are, Squire. King Louis, would you help me be part of my crew? Come here. Give me a round of applause. Come here, Squire. You can stand here. Here we go. King Louis sailed the seven seas all the way from Loughton on the 167. Louis, will you do me a favour? Will you hold me mother? Thank you. Sorry, mum. Now, we have 1, 2, 3, 4, 5. Now, we need more to be a crew, don't we? Now, I did have some more members of my crew, but I don't know where they are. If you do see my crew, you need to scream and tell me if you see them. Do you see them? They are! They are! Where?
Yeah.
You're all lying! I give up! I can't do this no more! Everyone look! Yeah. You scared me! You scared me every day! Daylight's out of me, didn't it? Louis! They scared me, Louis! I didn't know what to do! They scared me! I suppose you think you're funny, don't you? Well, you shouldn't creep up on your captain like that.
Oh, yes we do, Captain.
Yeah, you always creep up on me like that. Well, guess what?
What?
Back to work.
All hands on deck.
Come here, let me, mate. Come here. Right, you've got a very important role. You need to make sure, look after me, mum. Take her out for a steak dinner if you can, yeah? Hold her high up. Look out to the audience. Give them a smile. There we go. Brilliant. Right. We need to get ship shape and main sets out to go to Westfield. I need to go to Stockton, buy some new jeans. If you don't do a good job, you'll be walking the plank.
But we don't have any planks, Captain.
Ah. You see, with this crew, we have plenty of planks. Right, get in line. Time for roll call. That's it. Get in line. Right, now, Louis, we're going to walk down the line, make sure that they're all in line. Can we make sure that they're all in line? Are they all in line? Look like nice ones, really good, no gaps and all that. Show us your teeth. Good, you brushed them. Hang on, where's Gibbs?
Where's Gibbs?
You're late.
Captain.
All of them worth the marks.
Every man worth
his soul. And crazy taboo. Ah. Right, Gibbs, walk this way. Gibbs, you taking fun of me? You better not be. Right, now, come stand here. We're going to have a little look at him. King Louis, you've got to look after me mum. You're going to look after me mum for me. I made him cry. That weren't part of the script, was it? Oh, no, it's all right, mate. Look, it's me. It's Tony. We'll take that out of the DVD. The show was 2 hours long. Now it's 3. Sorry. Right, Gibbs. We're going to have to check, make sure that everyone's in line and in crew. Right, you, where's the parrot? The parrot, step forward. I remember their name. Cotton, do you have the courage and fortitude to sail the seven seas and set children in pirate's clothing and survive all that stuff and look for you in danger with your own pretty eyes? Cotton, answer me.
He's a
mixer. What? Cotton's parrot, same question. Winter's out! Wait, Dennis, how? You should work on a game show. She's really good, isn't she? Right, back in line. There we go. Right. You, lady, there. You step forward. What makes you worthy of being part of the Black Pill? Yes, indeed. I bet she's got a bus pass. Right, kids. Superb. You, sailor. What makes you worthy? Alright, language. Man after me, untrue art. Come on, step up, mate. There we go. Get back in line. Gibbs. Hide the rum. You, sailor, what make you worthy, eh?
Ever since I was a little lad, I've dreamed of sailing the seven seas. Forever.
Ooh, sooner than he thinks, eh?
Thank you very much.
Oh, manners goes a long way, doesn't it? I really like it. Right, Gibbs, come here. Step into my office. Let's have a little conversation. What do we think of the new crew? Comme ci, comme ça, I know. But unfortunately, that's what we got tonight until tomorrow night when the other cast come in. Well, we'll have to do with them, won't we? You all look ship shape and ready to set sail. Drink up, my hearties!
Yeah!
All aboard the ship! Oh no, look! We're under attack! Cannons! Some say, to survive this world, you have to be as mad as a hatter, which luckily, I am! you! I'd recognize you anywhere! Look, everybody!
Turn it up. I feel brave. Cause everything changes. And you can hold on to forever. The moment you do, you will see through into wonderland. Take my hand and we march into wonderland. Take my heart, take my hand and we march into wonderland. Take my heart, take my hand and we march into wonderland. Take my heart, take my hand as we march into wonderland. Take my heart, take my hand as we march into wonderland.
The smash hit musical Matilda has been a global success and is a huge favorite with our students. Next is our students bringing to life some of their best love numbers from this wonderful new musical, Matilda.
Have you ever wondered, will I have a bad when I say same red? For example, there's no way of knowing if red means same thing in your head. If red means in my head when someone says red. And if we are trapped at almost the speed of light, we'll hold the light, the light will still travel away from us. The full speed of light proceeds right in a way. But I'm trying to say, for sure, it's just inside my head. I'm just a bit different from some of my friends. These answers come into my mind unbidden. These stories delivered to me for the written. And when someone shouts, they just seem to like shouting. This noise in my head is incredibly loud. I wish you'd just stop. My dad and my mum telling these stories for stop, but just once. I'm sorry, I'm not quite explaining it right. But this noise comes anger, and anger is like it's burning inside me. Usually pain, misery today, and the heat and the shouting, and my heart's pounding, and my eyes burning. Suddenly, everything, everything is quiet. Like silence, but not really silent. Just that still, sort of quiet. Like the sound of a page being turned in a book. Or a pause in a walk in the woods. Quiet. Nice, kind of quiet. The sound when you lie upside down in your bed. Just the sound of your heart in your head. And though the people around me, their mouth is still moving. The words they are reach me anymore, and it is quiet.
I am born. Like I said, into the eye of the
And when the sun comes up. strong enough to carry all the heavy things you have to hold around with you when you're a grown up. That you have to fight beneath the bed each night to be a grown up. And when I grow up, I'm gonna have dreams every day. I'm not playing with things I'm hungry for. When mom's jumping up on me, and I don't know.
Enjoyed the weird and the wonderful, presenting shows like The Jester's Ball, Lost in Wonderland, and Trick or Treat, and tonight is no exception. Roll up, as we take you to the Haunted Circus.
8-1-9 on Halloween, friends travel through the forest. Who would be the bravest and not let out a scream?
I appeal to a particular crowd. What do you want?
We run away from
the party. Oh, I see. You run away to join the circus.
That's right. You got it.
Well, you're not going to join this circus. Find a new one.
Guys, I think we should go.
Yes, I think you should take your friend's advice.
What, you don't want us?
Oh, we'll take you in if you want. It's a simple contract. Want a sign?
But there's nothing written on it.
I like to keep things simple. You are? Good. Welcome to the Haunted Halloween Circus. Welcome aboard!
Magical area.
Stuff, but does he know how to wind you up?
Come on.
Being good, I tried it once, Wednesday boy, and I found it quite tough. Eccentric, some say, but I like it that way. Now I'm going to show you, hear what I say. The circus of heaven is a mysterious place. Your dreams will be banished with no trace. My cheese and I'll switch this next one. This is Big Bro, taking over the show. With this new flow,
you need to listen up. skies the same. It's clear this time to rain. We're doing a pattern of things. I know you ain't ready for me.
You lose, you wear my shoes. You freeze, brand new. Me and the crew. Don't try, I'll flow. If your tongue don't grow, you lose control. We just wait to go.
This is Big Bro, bro. Taking over the show. Show with this new flow.
We need to lessen up a little bit.
Cause we won't quit.
Thank you.
Ladies and gentlemen, boys and girls, Stage One would like to take this opportunity to thank you all for your support over the last 25 wonderful years. Huge thanks to all our students, past and present, and our inspirational Stage One team. Thank you. Here's to the next 25 years. Good night.
Yes. Let me see you move. Come on, come on, come on. Yes. Let me see you move. I like you, oh, hold me all today. I've never felt so fine. Let it die above my I like you, oh, me, oh, me. And the night is gonna be just fine. Gotta fly, gotta see. Like you hold me, hold me. Ooh, baby, I've never felt so good. And I doubt it ever could. Like you hold me, hold me. In the night, through the thick and thin, gotta fly, gotta see.
The last night for some of our cast. Where are they? I think just some of the smaller people standing here. Give them another round of applause. As you can see, they've worked really, really hard. And for some of them, I think it's probably your first show. Yeah, is your hands up if it's your first show? It's quite a lot of them. Yeah. So I just want to take this opportunity tonight to say a big well done and thank you to our cast of tonight and Wednesday, and to all the chaperones that have helped them backstage, because to get everybody on and off and change is quite something. So without them, it wouldn't happen. It wouldn't happen. I'm not sure if they'll come out or not. Some of them are a bit shy. Are you coming out, chaperones? No, not coming out. Maybe tomorrow. Yeah, come on. Come on. No? Oh, tomorrow. Maybe tomorrow. So, like I said, I want to say a really big well done and thank you to you all, because you've been absolutely fantastic. You've worked so, so hard. And I hope that you're going to come back tomorrow and join us at the party, because we're going to have a party at the theatre after the show tomorrow, which I think starts at about 8.
8 till late.
There you go. So all the children that are in the cast and the family and parents are invited to come along. It's just going to be in the bar. Even if it's just for an hour or so, it'd be really nice for the kids to come along and join the others. So maybe we'll see you tomorrow. And if we don't, we'll see you at class. We're having a week off and then we'll be back, yes? But before we go tonight, we've got a message from our patron who really wanted to come, but he couldn't be here because he's filming the Dad's Army film. But Rebecca's going to read you a speech that he wanted us to read now.
Ladies and gentlemen, as patron, it was always my greatest wish to be with you tonight to celebrate 25 years of Stage One. Unfortunately, due to filming commitments, I can't be with you, but I know from past experiences that it will be a hugely enjoyable night for you all. Many congratulations to every single performer for all your brilliant hard work and dedication to both rehearsals and tonight's show. He says, I can remember my first solo Michael Jackson routine to Man in the Mirror, like it was only yesterday. I know how nerve-wracking it can be. So well done for everyone for getting through it. I hope you all enjoyed yourselves, as that's the most important thing of it all. Also, to all you mums and dads, and I really mean that as well from Daniel, for helping all the kids every step of the way and getting changed and stuff. Most of all, I want to extend a huge heartfelt thank you and appreciation to the unbelievable hard work, sacrifice and talent of Caroline and everyone behind the scenes for not only making tonight possible, but the past 25 years. Stage One meant everything to me. It represents a place where you can break through your inhibitions, grow as a performer and perfect your craft. Caroline, we are in awe of your achievements. You have given us such wonderful and enduring memories over the years. Thank you, and long may it continue. Best wishes, Daniel Mays.
I'd just like to say as well a really big, big, huge thank you to all the teachers, Rebecca and Tony and Shelley and Emily, Lauren, and of course the person who I think may have got to see a little bit of the show tonight, Sally, who you all know. So thank you for all your hard work. Hopefully we'll see some of you again tomorrow night, and if not, we'll see you soon, and maybe at the party, that would be great. But for now, we have to finish and go home. Thank you very much, everyone. Well done to you guys. Well done. Woo! We go off now. We say goodbye. Say bye. Say one bye bye.
Yes. Let me see you move. Come on, come on, come on, come on. Dance. Let me see you move.
Love never felt so good. Can't die, be never good. Not like you hold. Hold me all today. Felt so fine. And a dark above mine. I like you, hold me. Hold me. And the night is gonna be just fine. Gotta fly, gotta see.
So fine, and I doubt if it was ever mine. Not like you hold me, ooh, baby. Love never felt so good, and I doubt if it ever could. Not like you hold me, hold me. In the night, through the thick and thin, da-da-da-da. So good, oh, good.